June 12th, 1942. I hope I will be able to confide everything to you, as I have never been able to confide in anyone.
And I hope you will be a great source of comfort and support. Sunday, June 14th, 1942. I'll begin from the moment I got you, the moment I saw you lying on the table along my other birthday presents.
I went along when you were bought, but that doesn't count. On Friday, June 12th, I was awake at 6 o'clock, which isn't surprising, since it was my birthday. But I'm not allowed to get up at that hour.
So I had to control my curiosity until 6:45. When I couldn't wait any longer, I went to the dining room, where Mortza, the cat, welcomed me by rubbing against my legs.
A little after 7, I went to Daddy and Mama, and then to the living room to open my presents. And you were the first thing I saw, maybe one of my nicest presents.
Monday, July 19th, 1943. Dearest Kitty, North Amsterdam was heavily bombed on Sunday. There was apparently a great deal of destruction. Entire streets are in ruins, and it will take a while for them to dig out all the bodies.
So far, there have been 200 dead and countless wounded. The hospitals are bursting at the seams. We've been told of children searching forlornly in the smoldering ruins for their dead parents. It still makes me shiver to think about the dull, distant drone that signified the approaching destruction.
Wednesday, April 5th, 1944. I don't want to have lived in vain like most people. I want to be useful or bring enjoyment to all people, even those I've never met.
I want to go on living even after my death. And that's why I am so grateful to God for having given me this gift, which I can use to develop myself and to express all that's inside me.
When I write, I can shake off all my cares. All my sorrows disappear. My spirit is revived. But, and that is a big question, will I ever be able to write something as so great? Will I ever become a journalist or a writer?
Saturday, July 15th, 1944. Anyone who claims that the older folks have a more difficult time in the annex doesn't realize that the problems have a far greater impact on us. We're much too young to deal with these problems, but they keep thrusting themselves on us until, finally, we're forced to think up a solution, though most of the time our solutions crumble when faced with the facts.
It's difficult in times like these. Ideals, dreams, and cherished hopes rise within us, only to be crushed by grim reality. It's a wonder I haven't abandoned all my ideals. They seem so absurd and impractical. Yet, I cling to them because I still believe, in spite of everything, that good people are truly good at heart.
It is utterly impossible for me to build my life on a foundation of chaos, suffering, and death. I see the world being slowly transformed into a wilderness. I hear the approaching thunder that, one day, will destroy us too. I feel the suffering of millions.
And yet, when I look up at the sky, I somehow feel that everything will change for the better, that this cruelty too shall end, that peace and tranquility will return once more. In the meantime, I must hold on to my ideals. Perhaps the day will come when I'll be able to realize them. Yours, Anne M. Frank.
Tuesday, August 1st, 1944. Dearest Kitty, the voice within me is sobbing. You see, that's what's become of you. You're surrounded by negative opinions, dismayed looks, and mocking faces, people who dislike you, and all because you don't listen to the advice of your own better half.
Believe me, I like to listen, but it doesn't work because if I'm quiet and serious, everyone thinks I'm putting on a new act, and I have to save myself with a joke. And then I'm not even talking to my own family, who assume I must be sick.
Stuff me with aspirins and sedatives, feel my neck and forehead to see if I have a temperature, ask about my bowel movements and berate me for being in a bad mood, until I just can't keep it up anymore. Because when everyone starts hovering over me, I get cross and sad.
And finally end up turning my heart inside out, the bad part on the outside and the good part on the inside, and keep trying to find a way to become what I'd like to be and what I could be if only there was no other people in the world. Yours, Anne M. Frank.